In the wake of recent shootings and protests and demonstrations, it was seen that the city of Charlotte was in great pain, and that the pain was deeper than one incident or one shooting. We all know that it was historic. It reflected systemic injustices that exist within the city, disparities around poverty, around jobs, around homes. One Charlotte was started to acknowledge the pain and to put into action a plan that would address core systemic issues that create inequities in the Charlotte community. The goal of One Charlotte is to drive coordinated action and a path forward for Charlotte. We want to be inclusive of all community voices to realize sustainable outcomes and progress for those who need hope and for those who need opportunity.
We fall down, but we get up. We fall down, but we get up. We fall down, but we get up.
One Charlotte. Yes.
For a saint is just a sinner who fell down, but we couldn't stay there and got up. Say now.
We fall down,
oh, my,
but we get up.
Get back
we
up.
Fall down.
Yeah, yeah, yeah,
but
yeah,
we
yeah.
get up, we fall down.
Oh my, my.
So when I see that one Charlotte, yeah, it'll help, but everybody got to come on board with this thing here. It can't just be a little piece here. All diversities have to come together if you want it to be one Charlotte. Right now, we should call this each man for self. Yeah, I'm scared to walk the streets at night. I got locks, but I'm a good person. I'm that negative. So don't get it twisted, okay? I just want to provide for my family and provide for my community, as you see.
But at this point, if Charlotte wants to change, they have a decision to make. You're either going to be different. You're not going to go with the status quo. You're not going to go with what your voters may tell you to do, but it's the right thing to do. So they have to make a choice, and that's the only way that there will be unity. Because once you do that and once you make a choice, people who look like me will trust you. People who look like me will vote for you. But if we continue to be and to do what everybody else is doing and not make a change, then people like me won't trust you and you won't bring that community back.
I think it would be a great improvement if the public in this city knew where we could go to have conversations with police, to have conversations about incidents which we think may not have been handled correctly. I think that there should be a more open form of communication and maybe a place where we feel safe and we feel like we can talk with police or with someone from the city about incidents or occurrences that we've had in dealing with police that we thought were unjust.
I felt safe out there as white guy with a camera. I didn't feel threatened at all. And I think that the whole, you know, riot of Charlotte was a little bit of an overstatement. You know, stuff turned sideways, but, you know, that was kind of a reaction to what the police were doing too. So it's a super complex issue. But I think talking about it in the right terms and realizing that people were justified in their anger can help the process go a little bit further and help solve those things. And if that's what One Charlotte's trying to accomplish, then that's a good thing to do.
One Charlotte for me means blending. That is blending in the sense of bringing all the voices in the community together, all of them, from the traditional leadership we have defined to those who are not so traditional, so that they have a seat at the table, so that they can hear each other and hear each other in a safe environment where we can really get at our issues in depth so that we can bring about solutions that are longstanding.
We have to start paying attention to the neighborhoods that we drive around every day. You know, I know that most of our journeys in and out of the city don't take us through the very neighborhoods that we actually have to acknowledge. Once we start acknowledging the people that we've been driving around, and we absolutely include them in the prosperity that is taking place right now in this city, I think we'll start having solutions. We'll have real talk, because today we're not talking about the issues of race. We're not talking about the gaps that exist in the unemployable individuals out there. And we're not talking about the real issues, because we're not thinking it's us. We have to embrace the fact that they are us. And if they don't succeed, we cannot be successful.
This first starts with dialogue and building trust. We have to have the conversations, and difficult conversations, and we've got to listen very patiently. And there's some things that may be said that we don't want to hear, but that's really the road to building trust and foundation that's going to lead to action and really creating One Charlotte.
Important for Novant Health to understand the needs truly of everyone inside of Charlotte. So instead of us as an organization trying to create solutions that we think people need, we need to stop, we need to listen, and we need to better understand what people really want.
I think the local officials should show up in the communities that they serve, where they are elected, not when something bad happens, but they should build a relationship and a rapport with the citizens so that when something does occur and there is an immediate need for action, the citizens and the people in the community know who to talk to. They have a relationship and there's a respect and a trust that is built when you constantly work on growing a relationship as opposed to calling someone when something bad happens.
I think communication would be key. I think a little forum with our local police officer and our local sheriff. Coming to a neighborhood like this and, you know, show that they're not, you know, bad cops, not scary, you know. So, and I mean, it touches me because I have a 20-year-old son. So, you know, when he goes out at night, you know, back then you used to think about, Lord, keep him safe, you don't get no accident. And now I gotta say, low key, say don't let him get shot, you know, so.
I think trust is very important, and transparency is probably the most important that'll lead to trust, right? I think that if our leaders and our church people are transparent with the community, it'll help to help the community and the young people feel more comfortable and feel like, man, you know what, you do have my best interests at heart. You are interested in the good of me and the people around me, right? So I think transparency and trust is huge. If I don't trust you, then I'm not gonna follow you, right?
We've got great prosperity in Mecklenburg County. We see the gleaming new buildings, buildings going up all the time. It's wonderful. But if we don't address the issues of access to that prosperity, all of it will have been built on a foundation of sand. In other words, the problem of poverty is not just a problem for poor people, it's a problem for all of us, because we are paying for it.
Charlotte is a community that cares for everyone. That cares for those that have been here for generations. It cares for those of us that just came here recently. It cares for those of us with children that are growing up here with two languages. It cares for children that have two cultures in their life, but still love the United States, but still appreciate both their heritage from other places as well as the heritage here. And they just want to make this a great place.
So for me, the first thing that comes to mind is my first couple weeks here in Charlotte. I moved here about 2 years ago, and during that time frame, our second child was born. And I think about the day he was born, and in the hospital that day, there were six or seven other little babies that were born. And you see the excitement on each of the parents' faces, and you know, you think about all the families that, you know, are bringing these children into the world. But then you think about the reality of that not every child has that same opportunity. And for me, that's what One Charlotte's all about. It's how do we ensure that every family, when their child is born, knows that this community cares deeply about them the same way that I know that this community cares deeply about my child.
I think there are several solutions. I don't think there's one specific methodology. I think we need to apply different strategies, get different people, because, I mean, quite frankly, think about it. Charlotte is a melting pot, right? You've got so many people here. It's very diverse. I'm pretty sure if you think about who we have in public office, the community leaders and so forth, everybody has an idea. Why not look at the top 10 and start planning and implementing those solutions?
The challenges are great. I don't think one task force is going to solve all of Charlotte's problems. That's, you know, why we're building a co-working space on the west side. It's, you know, I think it will be big things like One Charlotte. I think there'll also, it's up to a lot of us that have the power to make things happen to also get out there and try to bridge that divide in any way, shape, or form. So yeah, these top-down things are really good, but that doesn't stop me from moving forward with something from the ground up.
The biggest challenge for One Charlotte is going to be including people that don't really feel like they trust, they feel that they're disenfranchised. And so you have to have that group of people come in and talk to you about their lives, their experiences. You need to listen to some stories of people that are not a part of our economic opportunity.
At our church, we have a saying. We say we make soup, not salad. And when you ask somebody, what's an American look like, they can't answer because it's not driven by ethnicity, it's an ideal. And so I believe that as we get together and we build something great together, we get to know each other, and then true unity takes place. So a common goal, common vision, and then a common commitment that we will embrace and love one another, we can do this.
I'm an old country boy, and they always told us that the way you eat a hog is one plate at a time. So this is not one of those situations where we're going to be able to tackle and do it all overnight. But I do think that there are places where we have opportunities that we can start.
In the grand scheme of things, one of the things I've been saying is that we really need, as Americans, as freedom-loving people, we need to deconstruct the institutions that are systemically and systematically corrupt and have been for decades and hundreds of years. We have to be willing to do the hard work to deconstruct these institutions and build them back piece by piece, because we do need a police force. You know, a society of laws needs a resource to help enforce those and help keep the peace and help to uphold the general well-being and the domestic tranquility that is outlined in the Constitution.
As we all have expressed our anger, our concern, our hopes, our dreams for our community, it's going to take all of us to create the type of community not only that we can be proud of, but that our children will be glad to inherit. It's going to take everybody to produce One Charlotte.
That right there saved a lot, saved a lot.
One Charlotte.
Hey, One Charlotte. One Charlotte.
One Charlotte.
One Charlotte.